too many people keep reporting to us that they're eating too much, moving too little, drinking too much, and feeling like trash. Good news, there is a solution. Hey, I'm Sarah Curry from Blaze Yoga and Pilates, and today I want to talk about your 5 top tips to break your COVID funk. Always, at the advice of our friend and colleague Aaron Holt, we start with the low-hanging fruit, and these are 5 simple things you can do immediately to start feeling better. Once you feel better, you'll get yourself on a roll to actually doing more of the stuff that makes you feel amazing. Numero uno, drink your water. Sundays are my day off. I always have the hardest time hydrating on Sundays because I don't get up in the morning and pack a water bottle before I head off to work. So think about it this way and break it down. You may need to pack yourself a water bottle when you wake up in the morning to make sure that you're drinking water throughout the day. What's your basic equation for how much you should be drinking? Take your body's weight in pounds, that number, slash it in half, and drink about that many ounces of water. If you're working outside, working out, sweating a ton, you'll need to beef up your hydration. Yes, you can get it from soup. Tea absolutely counts. Some of the even coffee you're drinking counts towards it, but make sure that you're hydrating through the day because most of your body's systems don't function without water. So for you to stop feeling so sluggish, you've got to be hydrated. Number 2, fuel your body. Obviously the body, your mind, your brain can't function without fuel, and I follow a couple of Aaron Holt's simple tips. Number 1, no caffeine on an empty stomach. Number 2, eat within 1 hour of waking up. Eat real food and enough for an adult human being. 2 of the things, hashtags you can follow online if you're trying to sort of figure out like what's normal. 1 is hashtag Hattie Breakfast, so you can eat more than a 4-year-old. And the 2nd is hashtag Andy Snacks. It's A-N-D-I-E Snacks. So you guys can see what Andy eats in the morning for breakfast. Hint, it's a lot of freaking food. And then the 3rd rule is if you need a snack to make it from breakfast to lunch, your breakfast isn't big enough. You need to be eating more food and more fuel, so that's a great way for you to check up. Obviously, we all know you need to eat a lot of fruits and vegetables, lots of whole foods, nuts and seeds and stuff like that is great for your body. If you don't have any idea about that, the most effective, simplest, and quickest way to do it is to check out Aaron Holt's Eat to Achieve program. It's $99 for a 21-day lifestyle program that's just gonna sort of teach you about eating whole foods and fueling your body and how to make sure that you're sleeping well and all that type of stuff. So if you need that education, it is literally the most affordable way on the market to get yourself some of that education. It's a self-study program. It is absolutely not a diet, but it can help you start eating food so that you're actually fueling your body and feeling good. Now, one of the things people keep saying is that they're eating too much junky food. So here's the deal. If you don't buy it at the grocery store, it won't be in your house, but it's fun to do stuff like make things and bake treats. So if you want to have treats, what if you just thought about like make it yourself? Not out of a box, but like literally from scratch. Look up a recipe. It'll give you something interesting and fun to do, and then it makes that treat that you're having something special. It also takes a heck of a lot more time than it does to reach your hand into a box of Cheetos. You can tell how many Cheetos I eat. I think they come in a bag. Number 3. You have to move your body. Did you know that the American Health Association says if you would like to retain your current level of cardiovascular health and wellness, that you must exercise for a minimum of 60 minutes, 7 days a week? And if you would like to improve your cardiovascular health, they recommend 90 minutes a day. 7 days a week, not 30 minutes 3 times a week, right? You've got to move your body to feel good. When you move your body, you are literally helping the way your body functions. Your immune function, your circulatory system, the way that your muscles transmit fluids and stuff in between them, all of that function even better. You have got to move your body. I know the inertia of being at home can make it feel really hard to like get up and get going. So, what would motivate you to get going, right? Getting someone in your house to go for a walk with you. One of the things Jalen and I do every day, we film yoga and Pilates in the morning, but every afternoon we go outside and take a walk. It might be 20 minutes, it might be 70 minutes, it might be a mile, it might be 5. But we look forward to that time to walk together and talk, to make plans, to talk about how the day has been going. So what could be your movement thing that you really want to do every day? Obviously, you know we're pumping out tons of content. There's over 169 videos currently in our video archive so that you can grab a workout that's 4 minutes long to 90 minutes long, whatever you need for the day, or mix and match and make your most fun. If you like loved the Donkey Kong cardio kick, do that one a couple of times a week. Get yourself motivated. Whatever it is you like to do that you have to move at some point in your life, Movement's gotta be a non-negotiable, a habit. You would never go to work without brushing your teeth, right? So don't go throughout your day without moving your body. The fourth low-hanging fruit that you can do during these challenging times is go outside. No matter where you are or where you live, get yourself outside of your surroundings and just be out there. Whether that means you're sitting on a bench watching birds or you're gonna walk around your yard or down the street where you live, being outside in the fresh air helps to improve endorphins and feel-good hormones in your body. It's also gonna help if you're getting a little bit cagey and a little bit of cabin fever. So even if it's for a super short period of time, get yourself outside of your physical residence, outside of the place that you work. Spend a little bit of time outside, see something new. We don't usually in our regular day-to-day lives have the time to do that type of stuff. So now that we do have the time, make it a priority. It is guaranteed to boost your mood. And then last but not least, you're not gonna wanna hear this. Lay off the sauce, right? This is not the time for day drinking, right? Maybe the first couple of weeks you did that type of shenanigans, but alcohol is a depressant. So even if you're saying, hey Sarah, I'm only drinking 3 days a week, the depressive effects of alcohol last in your body for 7 days. So if you wanna be depressed for the next week, go and have a drink. And remember that the reason alcohol makes you feel high is because it is finished by an alcohol group, an OH, and that is running around rampant trying to steal hydrogens from other chemicals around it. That's the reason it's used in a laboratory to prevent contaminants, because it destroys cells. Alcohol, you're in a time where you're trying to have your best immune function. Alcohol is an immune system suppressant. Right? So if you want to be your best and feel your best and not be depressed, it also interrupts your sleep, right? So we got to sleep, we got to move, we got to eat, and if you want all those things to be doing it, alcohol is not actually helping you. So as you're getting ready to work your way back into the studio, as we get open, you're going to have to lay off the sauce anyway, because you will feel like trash if you come in here after having 3 cocktails last night. So this might be the perfect time. It's starting to get nice outside. It's beautiful. You can do lots of fun things in New England in the springtime. So maybe you can start to swap out that afternoon cocktail for your afternoon walk. That's it. 5 simple low-hanging fruit. Almost every single one of them is free, except for the food you've got to grab, right? Drink water, fuel your body, move your body, get outside, and lay off the sauce. And we'll hope you'll be feeling better really soon.